Hey everybody, I found out that lots of people still have some doubts and queries about homemade air dry clay or cold porcelain clay. So I decided to make this special tutorial on how to make clay and some tips and tricks about working with the clay. So let's check the recipe first. Welcome to my kitchen. Today I'm going to make clay on stovetop. The main ingredients of this clay are corn flour and glue. I'm taking 1 cup of corn flour in this pan. And 1 cup of white glue. You can take any PVA glue. Mix them nicely. Make sure there should be no lumps. Now I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of vinegar or lemon juice. This is really important if we are going to store the clay. It needs preservative to prevent it from molding or fungus. Adding 2 tablespoons of oil. It can be any cooking oil or baby oil. And 1 teaspoon of white acrylic color. It is optional. If you are going to paint your artwork, then you can avoid it. But without white color, the clay will turn transparent. Mix everything properly. Keep your kitchen platform ready for kneading. Apply some body lotion or cold cream. You can use Vaseline. Now it's time to cooking. Keep it on low flame and keep mixing continuously. You need to mix continuously to avoid forming any lumps. When the clay start leaving sides like this, it means it's almost ready. When it will reach this consistency, turn off the gas and take clay for kneading. Put some lotion on hands and start kneading. You have to knead even if it is hot. You can add some corn flour if you think it's too loose, or you can add glue if you think it's dry. The more you knead, the more flexible and smooth it will get. And it's ready. Put some lotion. Pack it in airtight bag. Store in airtight container. Now let's see some tips to keep in mind before starting working with this clay. Always keep your clay away from open air as it dries so quickly. Take out small quantity as required and keep remaining closed. It does not need freezing. You can store it at room temperature. It is good for a week without using any preservative. With preservative, it lasts for months. Maximum I have stored it for 4 months and I'm sure it will last more than that. You can take teardrop test to check right consistency. If you pull the clay, it should form a teardrop. Coloring the clay. You can literally use any type of color to color this clay. Acrylic, watercolor, fabric colors, food color, dry color pigments, chalk pastels, or even markers. You can either mix the color or paint over it after drying. I personally find acrylic colors goes really well with this clay. I'm using acrylic color here. And you have to mix like this. You can make paper thin realistic flower petals with this and they won't break easily. You can use normal glue to attach two pieces. It is suitable for small figurines like this. This is tiny Santa Claus. And this is mermaid tail jewelry holder. These are some flowers I made with my homemade clay. You can make tiny succulents like this. This clay is even get used for jewelry making like this floral bracelet. It takes at least 24 hours to dry the artwork completely depending on its thickness. Figurines will take more time. It is not completely waterproof, it absorbs some moisture as it contains starch, but you can cover it with craft varnish or sealants. Still, I will advise you to keep your artwork away from water and clean them with just damp cloth. One more point to keep in mind that this clay shrinks after drying almost 15-20%. I have this butterfly made with the same cutter yesterday and this I am making today. So you can see the difference how much it shrinks after drying. Look at the difference of size. So always keep that in mind. A big advantage of this clay is it's really inexpensive and get ready with some basic ingredients. Easy to work with, dries in open air, does not need oven to cure it. I think I have covered almost everything about clay today. Still, if you have any doubts, please let me know in comments. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.